Your life in this janma is not the totality of all the actions you did in the past. It is the decisions you made about your past. Let me be very straight. For example, somebody has done 100 murder in the last birth. When he left the body, he was very clear, no, it brought so much suffering to me, I am not going to do any more. Then that 100 death, that will not have any impact on your present life. You may think, oh, it is unfair. He should suffer. He should go through. I do not know whether it is fair or unfair. I am stating as it happens. This is the way the law of karma is functioning. Whether it is fair or not, you can sue him when you see him. That I do not know. I am giving you the straight clarity. Please understand. These understandings will really help you to develop a strategy planning about your life. If you develop a strategy planning just with idea of 70 or 80 years as your life, it is called materialistic life. If you develop a strategy planning knowing all the secrets of life, death, life after death, from your existence till your disappearing into the cosmos, not death, understand? Not death, disappearing into cosmos means enlightenment. If you develop a strategy planning, having all those ideas clearly, it's called spiritual life, that's all. The material life and spiritual life, the only difference is not the way in which you act or live or anything. If you have the strategy planning, thinking you are going to live only 80 years or 90 years, of course Indians don't live that much because of that belly fat. All of you should be aware, Indians die 13 years, 13 years earlier, just because of the belly fat. The researchers are proving your liver, kidney, brain, everything can function 13 years more, average. But you die 13 years ahead just because of the belly fat, means heart problem. All over the world, the cardiac patients, heart patients, 60% are Indians. And Indians have 600% more heart problems and heart attacks. These are some of the statistics. Than any other race. See, whole list, next to Indians, whatever race is there, that race is the second level. We are 600% more than the second level person. Then understand. The difference between us and the next level is 600%. Our lifestyle and what is it? Just lifestyle. That is the main reason. Main reason why we suffer. Anyhow, if you think you are going to live only in this body and do strategy planning, it's material life. If you are clear about you start happening until you merge with the cosmos, till your enlightenment. If you are clear about the happenings and the secrets of what happens during the climax moments of your life, like a life happening, birth or death, different climax moments. With this clarity, if you develop a strategy planning, that is spiritual life. Understand? With this clarity, if you develop a strategy planning for your life, you will not be surprised or shocked during your climaxes. For example, if you have insurance to face certain accident in your life, you will not be completely pulled down. You may be shaken a little bit. It's not that you will completely fall. You can stand up again. You will be able to manage. Same way, if you have a strategy planning, knowing these basic truths of life and death, you will not be completely shaken. You will be shaken a little, but you can always stand up. You have backup plan. Please understand. So what I am sharing, if you imbibe intensely, you can revise your strategy planning. You will have backup plan for your death and life. One more thing, anything which you clearly think again and again, any idea which you keep as a base for your strategy planning will not be forgotten even during your death. Even during your death, you won't forget these ideas if you again and again take decisions based on these ideas. See, whatever idea you carry about you and make decisions will not be forgotten even in the end. Now these truths can give so much of clarity about your strategy planning. So when I saw that soul leaving the next level through the guilt, it was such a strong pain, such a heavy pain, that I did not do this, I should have lived like that, I should have done this, I should have done this. That guy says, I want to go back and live. Body says, no, get out. Then this fellow says, all right, at least next Janma, I'll undo all this. Whatever was strongly influencing him, whatever decision he made, next Janma I will do, that became one layer of karma on him. So when he leaves the body, first he acquires a strong pain and falls into coma. Second, he sees all his desire engram, acquires the layers and layers of desires which he wants to fulfill in the next body, sees all the guilt engram, acquires all the ways, guilts he wants to relive or undo in the next body, means accumulating karma. It's like a shopping mall. Both sides, too much is there. Whatever attracts your attention too much, you buy that. If nothing attracts your attention, you are too tall, then anything displayed. You are too shining, then anything displayed. You don't need, you are joyful by yourself. You don't need these things to give joy to you. You just walk through. Sometimes how you walk in the airport, both sides too much is displayed, but you are fulfilled. You don't feel those things can add joy to you. So even though all those karmas are there, you are not accumulating, you are just walking. All the items which are in the airport displayed are Sanjita. Whatever you buy is your prarabdha. After landing in the body, here what you buy is your agamya. I have clearly described three level karmas. Whatever is displayed in the airport, duty free. Actually, it is not duty free. When you buy, you start the duty. I saw the soul walking. When it crossed the guilt area, he buys so many things. Oh, I'll fulfill all this. Then he walks through all the pains he suffered in the life. All the pains, kind of a, all those pains are displayed there, alive. Either he picks up anger or vengeance or depression from those pains. If he has courage, he says, I'll go and finish that fellow off. This time I'll kill him. Anger. If he is not courageous, he gets depression. Oh God, if I go once more, he may kill me again. Depression. Or fear. He buys all these things in that shop. He walks through step by step like these different layers of his own being, his own engrams. Finally, I saw that guy just loaded so much, with so much of karma, he just took the body within few seconds. Within few seconds, he assumed the body. Please understand. Yamadharma describes this process in Kathopanishad. If any of you have read the book, Tibetan Book of the Dead, any of you have read that book? That describes this process very clearly. See that end of the Upanishad, in the commentary, one master writes, not the Upanishad itself, in the commentary, don't tell these secrets to people who are not qualified, your head will burst. I thought, why are they putting this condition? I saw really, people who are not qualified, if they listen all these things, they are not only not able to understand, they start abusing the person who told these truths. Ah, he is telling some stories. He is frightening us. He is threatening us. Please understand. I have no vested interest to frighten you. I am not funded by any company who is promoting death. I don't have any reason or process. I am just stating the fact as it is to you, presenting it to you. Maybe these ideas will change your strategy planning about life. That's all I expect. That's all I expect, nothing else. Anyhow, you took the body immediately. The whole process took, I can say, maybe 4 to 5 hours. I don't know exactly, but very long. But long before, doctors have declared that he is medically dead and went away. Please understand, I am coming back to the place where I was seeing this death. Doctors declared he is medically dead and they went away. This whole process was going on for a long time. I was able to see the whole thing. One worst thing happened was, this was such a strong experience on me, and I was not able to help to that person. Such a strong experience, because see, I had my own experience of enlightenment at the age of 12, but I did not have that system or technology or energy to help the person. I myself had my own experience. It's like I can swim and escape, but I am not able to save somebody. I was not able to drag. I did not have a boat to save somebody. So I was able to see the problem. I was not able to save. It's like if you see an accident directly, you can't eat for next 2-3 days. Same way, I saw the whole thing. It was such a strong pain on me. And one more thing. Of course, it was not pain on personal, like a personal, but a sympathy or the empathy. Because of that, it was such a strong experience. Anyhow, the Swami recovered. I really thought the Swami will die and that guy will recover. It happened in the other way. And still I am not able to solve this mystery. I have seen 20-30 incidents. If somebody in the neighbor next house dies, the old lady or old man who was sick in this house will recover. Still I am not able to understand that mystery, but it's happening. So this guy recovered. I didn't know how, why. This guy recovered, the Swami whom I was taking care of, he recovered. Because he recovered, I left the hospital and I started continuing my journey. And after some time I had my own death experience, very strong experience in Varanasi. That experience gave me the technique or method to help others who are in deathbed, to heal them and help them very peacefully, relax. Anyhow, it was a very strong experience happened in me. After that I myself had realized my avataric mission or whatever I wanted to do in my life. That's what clarity about my future happened. Then I came and settled down in the South India in Bangalore. Again I had a chance of attending one more death. Please understand. In Bangalore I was attending, taking care of one of our devotee. I was healing her. The next bed I saw one person was dying. The moment I saw this person is dying, I wanted to run away because I do not want to go through that same experience once more. But this devotee whom I was taking care, very old lady, she caught hold of my hand and said, no, don't leave me and go away. I am afraid. Please be here. She just caught my hand very strongly. I used to have those days a bracelet. She just held my bracelet very strongly and did not leave me, did not let me go. I stood there, because no other way, I stood there. Anyway, I had to watch the second death. But one great thing, this death was completely different. I saw very clearly, the moment that intense pain was awakened, this guy, instead of falling into coma, he became more alive, more strong. Because he became more conscious and alive, that pain just disappeared, started subsiding. Please understand, even if you have knee pain, a very simple technique, just become, close your eyes and see what is happening there. Become aware of what is happening there without labeling it as a pain. Just see what is happening. Like how kids see, look at a rose. They will look fresh, alive. Same way, look at that pain, very alive, without labeling it as a pain. Just as it is, you will see that pain will disappear. So the more awareness, pain will disappear. I saw this guy, this became a strong and more aware, the pain disappeared. And he started walking through his engrams. I saw very clearly, he was standing tall, alive, aware. He was standing 20 feet and desires are all like 4 feet, 3 feet. He just walked through the desires, did not pick up even one. It's almost like a royal salute. All the desires are like a soldier standing and saluting him. And he is walking through, tall. He is walking tall. Then I saw he was walking through his guilt. All the guilts are like a small ponies standing. And he was straight walking through, did not even see the guilts. Then through his pains, he did not pick up a single pain or anger or vengeance. I was shocked actually. It's like a, if you put a knife through the butter, how it will come out, that beautiful way he was coming out. It was too much. Then finally I saw, he was passing through his pain, did not pick up single guilt or depression or anger. He just walked through his castle body. Castle body is a where all the engrams are dumped, like your garage. Your car garage are in India, always below the steps, below the first floor steps, you will have that small shoebox where you dump everything. That's your castle layer, where all the useless, broken, unwanted, unused, worry diagram engrams are dumped. He walked even through that engrams layer, did not pick up anything, just walked through. Suddenly I saw, because he did not have any engram, he just became enlightened. He just left the body. It was beautiful enlightenment. I was really shocked. I saw, how come that first guy had such a worse death? And the second guy is having such a beautiful, peaceful, relaxed process and he became enlightened. It was very revealing for me. I inquired the family. The family was standing next. I inquired, is he a great Mahatma or enlightened being? They said, no. Why? What are you talking? He had a business and two wives and he was managing his family. I asked, no, is he used to meditate or he used to go to temples regularly or very spiritual person? They said, no, nothing doing. He's actually atheist. Not only will never meditate, will not even go to temples. I asked, did he had some guru blessed him or assured, gave him abhaya? They said, no, he never had any guru. Then I started meditating. Then what can be the reason? That guy had such a worse death and the second guy had such a beautiful death. It's not even death, it's practically enlightenment. How did it happen? When I started contemplating, a strong truth was revealed to me. Please understand, not for pride, I'm just stating the honest truth. If you are not able to catch it, forgive me, but I have to tell the honest truth as it is. I just realized, this guy has died in the presence of somebody who can support and assist through energy.